Welcome back to All G's React, man. We're about to get into some Freddie Gibbs. His album just came out, I believe, 3 to 4 days ago. Don't quote me on that, but I know it's fairly new. I've always loved anything I heard from Freddie.
Yeah,
Not no
every
mega
time.
fan, but I have definitely, anything I've heard from him, I have definitely loved it. So I decided it's time for me to start investigating Mr. Gibbs. What about you, Bruce?
Man, been a big fan. The whole channel Team Box could y'all go over there, you'll see that we've been a fan of Freddie Gibbs over there. His last album, well, mixtape album was dope. Every single that came before that, for the past at least, 6 years, 7 years, we've been
Huh.
on Freddie Gibbs, man. So
Okay,
I love
man,
it.
that's good, man.
Oh
I've only
yeah.
known about him for about two, about three, no, about 3 years now. I've known about him. Like I've seen his name pop up in features of other artists I listen to, but I just never took the time. But I told myself it's time for me to start taking time for these good artists. You know what I mean?
Well, I'm also from the Midwest, man. So I'm always looking for that Midwest flavor. You know he's from
Yeah,
Indiana.
well.
That's right across that's right across the street from us over there in the Chi.
Okay, all right.
We
See,
got a train
I
that
didn't know
goes
this.
right there.
Huh. That's cool. All right, so man, we got Freddie Gibbs, man. This is Paul Olive, and man, we got Pusha T, Killer Mike. Okay.
Yeah, when I saw that, how much you want to bet is
I mean, I don't never seem to go wrong with Killer Mike. I'm hit and miss with Pusha, you know what I mean? But
I'm a fan.
he's always done right,
Yeah, I'm a
you
fan
know.
of
But I
Pusha.
think,
Only thing is that seven song album, you already know. That's Kanye's fault. It's not his, man. I'm not gonna blame him for that. That's Kanye's fault.
that's hilarious. But let's go ahead and check this track out, man. See what we got.
Let's
All
do
right. Three, two, one. I like that. Oh. Yep. Killer Mike.
Play low.
Snowfall and Reagan gave me the visual. Obama
mama opened his doors knowing I was a criminal. I took a risk, I took a break, took a road trip to a Motel 6. Get it wholesale and you know I won't tell shit. Ride coattails, then he really won't that lit. Just another in the mix, nigga. I'm rich, nigga. Tell me is you an Alpo or Mitch, nigga?
Oh, man.
What you know about that beat with no snare in it?
I mean, but like this sample flip too.
What'd you say?
I said this sample flip as well.
It's crazy. What you know about the beat with just the girl singing and no snare drum?
Man.
A little guitar in the background.
You know a guy in my neighborhood, he came home from work one day, caught his best friend in the hall with his wife. They had all day to go to bed. Pulled out a 45 and shot both of them. Next morning, his friend went down to the jail. He said, Fred, don't take it so hard. He said, it could have been worse. He said, what you mean it could have been worse? He said, man, two people dead. I might get the electric chair. You tell me it could have been worse? I said, yeah, baby. It could have been worse. I said, what you mean? I said, hell, if you'd have came Thursday instead of Friday, you'd have gotten me too.
That's dirty. I have never been disappointed by Freddie Gibbs. I've never been disappointed.
That right there was a good ending. Oh, shit.
That was fire. Man. That was fire, man.
Well, you know, the crazy thing about it is we got a lot of drug references, a lot of homage paying to, like, man, Harlem crack era.
Uh-huh.
And the crazy thing, one of the craziest thing to me is the fact that you got Killer Mike on a hook and he didn't rap no verses whatsoever. And it still sounded great.
Fire. Absolute fire. Killer Mike blessed that hook. Talking about blessed that hook, boy. Fire.
That is crazy to me. That right there is crazy. I saw Killer Mike. I thought for sure when I saw Pusher's Time coming to an end, when I was watching that bar, I'm like, Killer Mike finna go in here and go crazy. Nope.
He just did that hook.
I'm like, huh. All right.
You know what got me, though? Let me tell you what this dude did so well. Yeah, it's a lot of the crack game in there. But it's two different ways of talking about it.
Yep.
Right? There's somebody who's actually been through it as a way to live and can tell a story without the glorifying. The guy goes seamlessly from forget the 40 acres and a mule. What they gave me was a hot pot with spoons, vanilla spoons. He's telling the story, interjecting Maxine Waters, the Reagan days, right? Like the history, it goes seamlessly from drug selling to history to politics to real life, right back to the swift hand of the mixer. Like,
yep.
When you can do that well, it comes from a life story. And an intelligent person has to say it. Intelligent person has to do it. Not every drug dealer is a rapper. Not every rapper is a drug dealer. But the ones that are real, that can do it well, tell stories like this that include the history, the politics, the understanding, and it's not a story of, what do you call that? A movie. It's not a movie. It's a life. And it's obvious. Man. I'm sorry. I kind of ranted there for a minute.
No, man, but the bars were so great.
Facts. You know,
the punchlines was great.
Facts.
And the surprising part to me, because how difficult it is for you to clear samples nowadays, you don't get a whole lot of sample flip like they had in this song.
True.
A lot of new songs nowadays. And that right there, to me, that's what stood out the most, because that's something that, you know, we kind of grew up on that, you know, hearing different samples being used and things like that, especially if you were heavy into the mixtape times.
Mm-hmm.
And now you don't really get none of that no more because it's so difficult to clear them. But they had her on there singing.
Boy, that was perfect. It and was like perfect.
You said,
man.
They pulled. They would you say they pulled the snare out?
They took the snare out of that thing. It took most of the drums out of it. All you heard was a crackle of the record in the background, and that little snare click in the back. I listened for it, but they took the drums out that thing.
Oh man,
and that's when you can rap over that so well. And Pusha is good at doing that, and I think that's because of the time he spends with people like Kanye and Pharrell. Like
right.
They push those types of beats on him. But yeah, that was fire, bro. Dead fire. Pusha did his thing. Your boy Gibbs just killed the first verse. I gotta listen to it at least 15 more times to catch everything.
Man, I am looking forward to this album now. I've been staying away from that album just so I can do this reaction.
Oh, I can't wait.
It's no holds barred now for me. I can get all up in this.
Listen, before we leave, all you got to do is keep watching because we're going to do an album review on the Team Box Cutter site. On the Team Box Cutter channel, the Basement Debates, y'all know what it is. We're going to do an album review of that one and another one. So, get ready.
Y'all head over there. Get over there. Get in them comments, man. Let them know, man. Listen to the album, too, so y'all can be prepared.
Yeah, listen to the album first. Or you could wait. But, you know, I would suggest everybody do their own. Because you can't let something like this just go. You got to listen to that thing.
Ride, man. Oh, I got to hear the rest of it now. All right, well, that right there, Freddie Gibbs. Killer Mike, Pusha T, Problem Olive, awesome. That's going to do it for me. I am Nixon. Bruce.
Peace.
And we're out of here.